Let's take a breather and deviate for a while. Let's talk about the draconian way of measuring rotation that we've studied all our lives and continue to use so far in this course. The degree. We all know that a circle is 360 degrees. 360 seems like such an arbitrary number. It must come from somewhere, must mean something, right? I honestly have no idea where that number comes from. There are a couple of theories linking the historical understanding that a year was 360 days in length, and other accounts which link to civilizations having a base 60 number system. But there is a more scientific, more grounded, more universal measure of an angle, the radian. I want to convince you to start using it because everybody else is. All trigonometric functions, when writing a sine function in a programming language, for instance, or when typing the sine function on a scientific calculator, they all expect the angle to be given in radian, not in degree. So what then is a radian, and why is it universal? You can think of a radian as a measure of the length of the circle that an angle represents. Instead of thinking about how many degrees of rotation is needed to go from one point in a circle to another, we think instead about the distance needed to be covered to get to that point along the path of the circle. A radian is basically a measure of the length of the arc that subtends an angle. An angle is said to be 1 radian if it subtends an arc of length equal to the radius of the circle. All right, but why is it universal? To understand this, we need to talk about pi. Whole books have been dedicated to the study of pi. So, keeping it brief, it's the ratio of the circumference of the circle to its diameter, and it's a universal constant, the golden number of 3.14159 and so on. So if the mathematics of rotation were to refer to this constant, we know that it'll be universally valid. The radian angle of a full circle is the length of the full circle, which is just the circumference of the circle. And the circumference of the circle is given by the formula 2 pi r. We know that the radius for a unit circle is 1, so the radian angle of a full circle is 2 pi. Half circle, were previously referred to as 180 degrees, is pi radian. Similarly, a quarter circle is pi over 2. So you can see a pattern here. The length of the radian or the radian angle is always expressed as a ratio of pi. An expression which has the value of pi in it should really only be evaluated at the final step of calculating the result. The reason is that the radian is not entirely intuitive in its calculated form. For example, try to visualize a circle whose angle is 1.74 radian. Hard, isn't it? It's hard to even know which quadrant this angle lies in. Is it less than a quarter of a circle? Is it more than half? Well, in the traditional sense, it's 100 degrees. Expressed as a fraction of pi, it's 5 over 9 pi, which is still not overly intuitive, but at least we can picture it in the second quadrant since it's over half the value of pi. To wrap things up, we can look at how many degrees are in 1 radian, and with that, a generalized formula for converting between the two. 360 degrees is 2 pi radian, and by proportional equality, how many degrees is equal to 1 radian? Solving for this equation, we get the value of 1 radian to be approximately 57.29 degrees, and the general formula for converting between the two. In the next video, we'll be resuming the discussion on sine functions, but now as a function of time.